All right, welcome back, guys. In this video here, we're gonna start discussing basic concept of probability. So this chapter is kind of on its own, which tied to the rest of the chapter, but in a way where these are just, you know, the concept that we discuss mainly on probability, and then at some point we're gonna in the next chapter we discuss how to use probability to tie to statistics. What we learn in this class. So it depends, you know, what kind of math class you have in high school. At some point, you may not seen probability before, but, you know, it's something that we use in everyday life. So for example, if I was gonna go hiking in Auburn tomorrow, I want to find out, hey, is it gonna rain tomorrow? How do I know that? What will be the likelihood of it's gonna rain? Should I check the news, or has it been raining this past couple days? So those kind of things that we, you know, make decision based on our experience, our circumstances, things that happen around us. Or another example would be, you know, I'm gonna pick one card from a deck of cards, and I wanna find out what will be the chance that, what will be the likelihood that I'm gonna get a red card versus a black card. So that depends on, you know, how many cards total and how many reds, how many blacks are there in a deck. So there's different way we are using mathematics to figure out our chance or the decision that we make. Is it going to be a good decision or not? All that has to do with probability. So the way we define probability is a mathematical measure of chance. Okay, chance is something that might happen. So notice that we use the word might happen, meaning there's also a chance that it won't happen. So with probability, majority of time we don't know for sure it's gonna happen. However, we have an idea, a good percentage that this event will happen, that that thing will happen, but it's very hard for us to know for certain that something will happen. And in mathematics, we capture the value of a probability that certain that it will happen, or 100% will happen, is when that event has a probability of 1 or 100%. So that brings us to the next thing, is the scale of probability. We say that anytime we describe something might happen or chance something happen, the value of that probability, the value of that event, will goes from 0 to 1. Okay, 0 being the event being impossible, or another word for event to not happen is improbable, right? So if you want to look at that as another way of describing it, improbable, something that will never happen. Whereas an event that we know for sure it will happen, or 100% sure that will happen, we call that event is certain. Okay, and anything in between, so the value of probability in between, we have 50% in the middle, which is 0.5. So this is like when we say, 50-50. You know, it's either black or white. You know, it's 50-50 chance that this event will happen, or this occasion will happen. And then we have the extreme cases. The extreme case would be the event, the probability for a certain event to be very close to certain, but not quite certain, but it's at really high end. So we define that from 0.95, 95% to 1. Between that, we say, an event that has that probability will likely to happen. So we can say likely to happen, right? Or the other extreme case where it's on the other end, where it's, you know, it's almost impossible. It still can happen, but the chance of that event happening is very, very, very small. For example, if your friend would say, hey, I won the lottery, I think I'm gonna win $400 million, and then you probably look at your friend like, are you crazy? I don't believe you, because the chance of that happening is very, very small, extremely small. So we have that other side to be go from 0 to 0.5, 0.05, and we say that events that have probability between 0% to 5%, we're going to say that it is unlikely to happen. Okay, so there it is. We have this scale we're going to go by and how we define probability value in our class. Notice that probability value is always greater than or equal to 0. It can't be negative, it can't be radical, it can't be irrational numbers. So it has to be between 0 and 1. Greater than or equal to 1, less than or equal, greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. And notation, some definition notation. We define an event is any collection of outcomes. Okay. A simple event is an event that cannot be broken down further, that has a single outcome. So the difference between simple event and event is simple event has only one outcome. Whereas an event, it has multiple outcomes, right? Sample space, we define sample space in probability is when we have a collection of all simple events of a procedure or experiment. Okay, and here comes notation. We said P denotes the probability of. And then A, B, C, these are just specific events in general and arbitrary, like A could be the event of tossing a coin and lands on heads, right? And then so P of A denotes the probability. So P of A now denote the probability. So P being the probability, A being events, the probability of event A occurring. Right, so P of A stands for the probability of an A occurring. P of A bar, so this denotes the probability of event A not occurring. So the A bar or the slash over the A mean not that or the complement of that. So we say, you know, so if we have these two probability, then we can say the sum of those will be 1, right? So, you know, looking at, you know, if I was to draw a card from a standard deck of 52 cards and I want to get a king of hearts, well, the chance of getting king of hearts out of 52 cards would be 1 over 52. Well, what would be the probability of me drawing a card from a standard 52 card deck and it's not King of Hearts? Well, there's other 51 cards left, so 51 out of 52. So that's the, you know, that's the P of A bar there. So when you take the sum of any events, the sum of the probability of any events and the probability of that event not occurring is always going to be 1. So we call this rule here, the complement rule of probability. Let me spell that right. Complement rule of probability. Here are some example of procedure outcomes and sample space. Okay, let's consider given a single birth. So the procedure be a single birth, okay. So for that procedure, you either have an outcome of a single boy or girl, right? Boy or girl, right? Because it's only one birth. So the sample space, we're gonna denote sample space as S. So the sample space is gonna be B, comma G, right? B for boy, G for girl. Right, let's move on to three births. So let's say we have three births, okay. An outcomes or an event would be, let's say I want an event of, let's say event A to be, you know, two boys and one girl, right? So if you have a family of three siblings, so the probability, the chance or the outcomes, different outcomes for that will be, you know, you can have the first two siblings will be boy and boy, and the last one will be girl, right? So in terms of birth, order matters because, you know, siblings, and it depends, you know, it's important that who were born first, who were born last. So boy, boy, girl would be one outcome. In this case, it would be a simple event. If we look at it, this would be a simple event. Okay. And then we can have a boy born first and then girl and then boy. Or we can have a girl born first and then two boys afterwards, because we want to restrict to the events of two boy and one girl, right? So these would be two, all three different scenarios of outcomes or simple event of this event A. And then now the sample space of this, the sample space, okay? So if we looking at all possible outcome, all possible result of given three births, and order matters, so order matters, okay? We can have the following outcomes. So we can have all three babies being boys and all three girls. So those are the two easiest one. Or we can have BBG, BGB, GBB. So how many, we got five so far. What else is there? So we can also have GGB or GBG. And so that gave us seven. There should be one more. We can have BGG, so boy first and two girls last. So these will be the all total of eight possible outcomes for a procedure that that involved three births. Now I want you to try on your own. If we were to extend this and say, okay, what if the procedure looking at is four different births here? What will be the sample space? So what will be the sample space? Okay. I'll let you work on that on your own. There should be 16 total. Okay. If you do it right, there should be 16 total. So now we can discuss. Actually, I'm going to pause on this video here, and I'll do part two of this on this page here.